Hi, this is Paul Solt from iPhone Dev TV. I'm going to show you how to get started with Xcode, which is the application that we'll be using on Mac to create our iPhone apps or Mac apps. Now, the first thing that you're going to need to do is download Xcode if you haven't already. So let's go ahead and go to the App Store. What you can do here is you can just search for Xcode in the top right. So let me highlight the mouse here. And if you just type in Xcode, you'll find Xcode along with some other development tools that work on development type stuff. We're not going to get into that. We're just going to look at Xcode. So I currently have Xcode installed right now. It's a 2.18 gigabyte download. And all you have to do is click this button and it will install it. So this is free to install and it'll take a little bit of time to download depending on your internet connection. Now, right now this is Xcode 5. So you can see the version number here. This is going to change when iOS 8 is out. That's going to be Xcode 6. So let me show you right now how you can get started with Xcode 6, which will allow you to do Swift development for iOS 8. All right, so what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to search for Swift and then Xcode. If I do something like this, you're going to see this first result, which is Swift Overview from Apple Developer. If you click on this, this is the development blog and introduction to Swift. So here you can see an overview. On this tab right here, they have a blog that goes over different topics, and then you have the resources section. So this is where you can get Xcode 6. Now, this is going to be updated, so when it is released, you'll get the latest version. You can read the release notes here. It is in beta right now, so that means it's not 100% working all the time. There are certain issues that are still being ironed out, but once it's out of beta with iOS 8's release, this will be a very good thing to download and to start making your apps with. So let's go ahead and hit download. When we do this, it's going to ask you to log in. Now, I've already logged in, so I don't need to do that again. You may need to create an Apple account, and then it's going to start downloading this. So it looks like if we look at the download size, this is 2.46 gigabytes that it's downloading. Now, I'm on a very fast academic internet connection, so this is going at 9 megabits a second. You're probably not going to, or 9 megabytes per second. So you're probably not going to get this type of download. So for me, it's really quick. For you, it's probably going to take an hour or two to download depending on your internet. So I'm going to stop that right now. And we're just going to jump over to Xcode in the next video. So this is the place to start. You're learning how to get set up with Xcode. All we're going to do is download this. Once you download it, then you're going to open it up. It's going to take a little bit of time to open up, so you might need to get a cup of coffee. And then when it's ready to go, come back and let's start with the next video. So thanks for watching. Let me know if there's anything I can do to help you make your first iPhone app.